In this video, we look at several AI-powered open source projects and commercial tools that recently started gaining popularity. All of them are leveraging large language models, and they either help you use AI for everyday tasks or help you build AI-powered software. Specifically, we look at autonomous agents, LangChain, Marvin, HeyGPT.chat, and YouTube Summary Chrome extension. Auto-GPT has been one of the top trending repositories on GitHub last week. It has gained close to 120,000 GitHub stars within just a couple of weeks, which seems a bit overhyped for what it can do at this time, but still it's a very promising project and it's worth following and contributing to. The purpose of this experimental open source project is to make GPT-4 fully autonomous and achieve any goal you want it to complete. It can be market research, it can do coding projects, it can write, and it can perform many more tasks. You can think of it as a virtual assistant that researches information, thinks what to do next, and learns from its experiences. It uses GPT-4 and has internet access. It preserves history of interactions by using vector source. It can write and execute code. It can interact with file systems, so it can read and write to disks. How does it work? It chains together thoughts. It then tries to criticize its own strategy and refine it. It then decides what next actions to take. Auto-GPT envisions a future where autonomous AI-driven tasks are the norm. What are risks and limitations? It can get expensive when you let it run for a long time due to its token usage. It can get stuck in a loop if it tries to get more and more information, do more research, and it never finishes the task that it was aimed to accomplish. Despite those limitations, it has huge potential because it can simulate human behavior. It's definitely worth following up, playing with it, and contributing to this open source project. Let's give it a try and see what it can do. The easiest way to get started with AutoGPT is to fork this Replit repository. Why am I recommending Replit is that installing it locally can be, to some extent, dangerous if you let it run fully autonomously for a while. Imagine AI making decisions about what to do next while having access to your local file system, your browser, and without being careful, you could potentially delete some files or perhaps even accidentally post something on social media. That's why I will use Replit. Here we can fork this repository. We'll wait till this environment will finish setting up. And then what we need to do is to configure secrets, which will be our OpenAI API key. Here we can just go create new API key. A good practice is to set usage limits. Now let's go back to our Replit environment. I added this as a secret. Now we can just run to trigger this AutoGPT. Once it will start, enter up to 5 goals. So my goal will be to write a script for a YouTube video explaining what is AutoGPT and what are its limitations and future potential. AutoGPT often gets stuck in a loop, trying to find more information instead of finishing the task efficiently. Now that I have some background information, I should define what AutoGPT is and its current limitations. I need to make sure I don't get too technical. Okay, so you can see that it keeps thinking and refining its strategy to complete the task that I have given it. I just let it run for a while and next we'll look at some alternatives. One alternative is BabyAGI. It's a language model interacting with a task list, prioritizing and executing this list without having access to the internet. Completed tasks are stored in a database that serves as a memory. This is a much simpler project. You can play around with it using this repository. Next up is AgentGPT. It can browse the web. We could give it the same task that we did to AutoGPT and see how it performs. Next up is gut mode. Here you can see examples. In which market should I first launch my vegan protein bars? Or write me a resignation letter to my boss at SAP. We can also just launch it and see what it can do. Then there's do anything machine, a to-do list that does itself for you. It also uses multiple agents working on a task autonomously. Then there is cognosis, which looks very similar to AgentGPT. There is also a Microsoft Jarvis project. The main limitation of ChatGPT Plus is that it was trained till September 21 and it doesn't have the current information. So for example, if I asked it, GPT-4 will not know the answer to this question because it's not in its training data. To overcome this limitation, we can leverage other tools such as LangChain. LangChain is a very flexible framework that can be used to simultaneously leverage various large language models and vector stores. You can load documents from various sources so that you don't need to rely only on data that the model was trained on. You can extend it with your own data. LangChain has great getting started tutorials that include notebooks you can download and just try out locally. Let's use LangChain to search for information about AutoGPT. To get started, I had to add OpenAI API key to my .env file, and we use .env package to load this environment variable. Then we use LangChain agents, chat OpenAI, and DuckDuckGo to search the internet. And the entire script is very simple. We configure those tools here. Here we configure which language model we use. We initialize the agent with our tools, language model, with the input text. And there is this very helpful package called Gradio that lets you build very simple front-end applications for your ML project. We just pass this function to GR interface. If we run it, what it did, it deployed this local application. And since we pass share is equal true, it also deployed a publicly available endpoint to our app. I'm passing the prompt, what are autonomous agents and why they are popular in the world of AI right now? And now it's thinking. So if we go back here to this, we can see the output. I'm not sure what autonomous agents are. It searches the internet for the answer. And now it just gave the answer. Autonomous agents are intelligent software programs that can work independently to achieve a single objective. They are popular in AI right now because they are seen as the next big thing in AI. And many experts believe they will help advance the field even further. So you can see here a very simple front-end application where we can not only use GPT 3.5 or GPT 4, but also search the internet and extend it with our custom documents. Next up is Marvin. Here is a GitHub of Marvin. It's batteries included library for building AI-powered software. It has AI functions and bots. It also ships with TUI, which is textual user interface, where you can have kind of like a front-end application accessible directly from your terminal. And you can use it to have the same user experience as with ChatGPT, but directly from your terminal. They also have very good documentation here, where you can explore different concepts, such as bots, AI functions, plugins, loaders to load your custom documents. So definitely check it out, and now we can see how it works in action. Here I defined just a bot and a DuckDuckGo plugin. I gave extraction to just be friendly and helpful, and to use this DuckDuckGo plugin to access the internet. We saved this bot. We defined this bot as name Ask Me Anything, Amma. So now I'll go to my terminal and I will just do. And I can provide the same prompt as here. This is our question. And again, we have the same answer as we got with Gradio. So yeah, that's how you can use Marvin. Next up is HeyGPT. HeyGPT is another tool that allows you to extend ChatGPT with your own data. What you can do is you can access Google search, you can upload PDF files, you can even upload Excel sheets and talk to them. You can ask questions essentially to almost anything. For now, they support PDF files, websites, and Google search, but soon you will be able to also ask questions to your Notion documents, Excel documents, video files, or audio files. And the way that works is that I can enter the website here. I can crawl it, or it will tell me how many tokens it will consume. I can access advanced settings to say what chunk size and chunk overlap to use. And then if I go to embed, it will be available here in kind of like a knowledge base that I can access. Then I can say, in order to ask my questions, select those websites. Okay. And now let's ask. Okay, so AutoGPT is built using those models as the robot's brain to help it think and reason. However, AutoGPT has additional capabilities as file manipulation, web browsing, and data retrieval. So yeah, it explained the difference. Now maybe let's ask something else. Based on the article we provided, what are the pitfalls of using AutoGPT? There are several pitfalls of using AutoGPT. Firstly, the experimental application is provided as is without any warranty. By using this software, you agree to assume all the risks. Lastly, the use of GPT-4 can be expensive due to its token usage, leading to economic inefficiency and raising questions about the practicality in real-world production environments. So essentially, it gives us information that ChatGPT could not answer because it doesn't have access to those websites. And what's also interesting is that it gives us sources that it used to access that information. Wikipedia, this AutoGPT repository, etc. So that's how you can use HeyGPT chat. One last tool we're going to look at will be this YouTube summary Chrome extension. What this extension does is first it generates a transcript of that YouTube video. And then you can, with one click, you can generate AI summary in just a couple of bullet points so that you don't need to watch a very long video and you can decide whether you want to watch it. So with that, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.